Buenos días, queridos alumnos de CELA Spanish School Online. In our class today, we will learn to spell in Spanish. Our theme is the alphabet. In Spanish, it is not as common to spell as it is in English. However, it is important to know the name of the letters. In Spanish, the letters have the feminine article. They are feminine words. We say la letra A, la A, la B, la C, etc. The alphabet is just the name of the letters. Pronunciation is what those letters and their combinations sound like. To learn the pronunciation of Spanish, we recommend watching our video on the pronunciation of Spanish on our channel. Let's start by explaining the alphabet in Spanish. Then we will practice spelling Spanish surnames. Please look for paper and pencil. Comenzamos. A. B. C. D. E. F. G. H. I. J. K. L. M. N. Ñ. O. P. Q. R. S. T. U. V. B. W. W. X. Y. Z. The letters K and W are not Spanish letters. We use them only in international words like kilo, kilómetro, whiskey, etc. Sometimes words are written with ka in Spanish for advertising purposes, to get attention. But it is not correct to write words with ka in Spanish. The letters che and elle were excluded from the alphabet because they are two letters instead of one. When I went to school, these letters were still in the alphabet. And now I'm going to explain something very, very important. In Spanish, we do not have double consonants. There is no double S, double T, double P, double M, etc., like in English. There are only double the following consonants. Doble C, as in acción. The first C is pronounced as K and the second as S, because it is followed by an E. Acción. Doble R. When the multiple vibrant R is inside a word, it is represented with doble R as in arroz. Doble L is the sound Y, as in pollo. Pollo. In some words, there is doble N, as in innato, or in llámenos. So, please, attention, dear students, never write doble S, doble T, doble M, doble D, doble P when writing in Spanish. It is an error. And now, as always, we will practice the explained. Let's spell some Spanish surnames. G A R C I A García. We do not mention the tilde when spelling, because the tilde is not part of the letter. The tilde is a mark for exceptions to the normal pronunciation of Spanish. In our video on the pronunciation of words and tildes, we explain the topic of tilde in detail. L O P, E, Z, López. R, O, D, R, I, G, U, E, Z. Rodríguez. Muy bien. Now, I'm going to spell some more surnames. Please look for paper and pencil to write down. ¿Listos? Aquí vamos. E. R. E. Z. Pérez. G. O. N. Z. A. L. E. Z. González. H. E. R. N. A. N. D. E. Z. Hernández. H. E. R. R. E. R. A. Herrera. M. A. R. C. A. N. O. Marcano. G. U. E. V. A. R. A. Guevara. S. O. S. A. Sosa. Surely you will wonder like me why so many Spanish surnames end in EZ. Formerly, this termination meant is the son of. For example, Fernández was the son of Fernando. Muy interesante. Muy bien. This has been our lesson today. Now, as always, you have to practice more. We invite you to visit our website and continue learning Spanish with us, either with our videos or with our online courses. Chao, hasta la próxima clase.